going on, everyone? Hugh Finn News coming at you with another daily cryptocurrency market analysis. Today is August the 27th, 2017, and we're going to go ahead and look at this cryptocurrency market capitalization to see what some of these cryptocurrencies have done today in trading. And then we start with number one, Bitcoin, up 1%. Last price was around $4,385, according to this website. Ethereum is up 3.39%. It had a pretty positive day today. Bitcoin Cash is down almost 1%. Ripple, almost down 5%. Litecoin is up 18.26%. And we just told you guys yesterday that Litecoin was still giving us precursors of strength and that it should move higher. And look, today it's almost up 20%. And if you guys noticed that Ripple and Litecoin has been making their way higher towards the market cap, and market cap wise towards the big other cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin, Bitcoin Cash, and Ethereum. So that kind of tells you guys there's a lot of interest for Ripple and Litecoin as well. Dash is down almost 7.5%. NEO is up 5.87%. Monero is down 5% as well, almost kind of like Dash. And our last one is Classic, Ethereum Classic, which is up almost 5%, and we forecasted that as well too. So let's go ahead, and the overall market cap is $158 billion. That's an increase of $2 billion. So as more and more individuals and people become interested in cryptocurrencies, this market cap will always increase. And just from yesterday, it increased almost $2 billion. So guys who are in the market for cryptocurrencies, you guys are in the forefront. So if you guys continue to stay strong, continue to be in this market, understand where the market is going to go, then you guys will be successful as these cryptocurrencies continue to make higher highs. So currently there's 865 currencies, 223 assets traded in 5,321 markets. So let's go ahead and get started. You know, we got to start with our number one, Bitcoin. Now, yesterday we said that the market was geared to move higher. They are down 0.5%. Last trade was $4,315.10. And if you notice on today, the market did shoot up higher towards 4,400, and there wasn't no interest to higher prices from that point, so the market closed lower than yesterday's bar. Yesterday we said it was a trial run. In order for this trial run to be successful, today's bar had to close higher. It did not do that, but I want you guys to notice the volume for today. That could mean two things. Either there's no interest to higher prices and the market will fall, or there wasn't that much selling going on to push the market lower, so the market will go higher tomorrow. Granted, we have this precursors of strength all the way in this background, so our analysis for Bitcoin is for it to continue to move higher. Next, we're going to go ahead and check Ethereum. In our analysis yesterday, we also forecasted that Ethereum was going to move higher. They are up 4.93%. Last trade, $349.12. And we mentioned on our video last night that we expected Ethereum to come and hit this high that occurred on the 21st of August of $346. And it did that today. So our analysis was correct again, and we're expecting, because today's bar was a push to go up, we have a lot of volume, and also the bar closed towards the top. This is a push to go up. So we're expecting Ethereum to continue to move higher. So next we're going to go ahead and check out Bitcoin Cash. So with Bitcoin Cash, you guys notice how the bar is wide. It went high and it went low, and the market closed in the middle right here around the area of support. So that tells us that consumption was coming in on this particular bar as well. We still are under the presumption here at Houfin News that Bitcoin Cash will be making higher highs. They are down 1.26%. Last trade was at $612.67. So now we're going to go ahead and check out Ripple. So looking at Ripple, we said yesterday in our video that they should move lower. They did, but I want you guys to pay attention to today's bar. And looking at it, it looks like a trial run. Look like some buying came in. So maybe Ripple is finding an area of support, a place to where all market participants can do business, and the market will continue to resume higher highs. But we have to wait for tomorrow's bar to see if it closes higher than today's bar. So our analysis for Ripple is for it to continue to move lower until we see a precursor of strength, which may arrive tomorrow. Okay, but they are down 4.52%. Last trade was around 20 cents, but today's bar gives us a change of character that the market is changing its way in which it wants to be moving. So next we're going to go ahead and look at Litecoin. Man, now look at Litecoin. Litecoin is finally right smack dab in the middle of this ascending channel. They are up 16.77%. Last trade was $60.02. We have waited a long time to see the market come back into the middle of this ascending triangle. We have forecasted that the market was giving us precursors of strength and that Litecoin should continue to move higher. And it gave us that today, but you can see that stockpile came in on this particular day on this bar. So tomorrow we want to see if the market participants are willing to buy up all of that selling that had occurred on today's bar. If so, Litecoin will continue to move higher. If not, the market will fall or trade sideways until they have finished consuming all of the stockpile within that area. But overall, Litecoin looks to continue to move higher unless the market closed lower due to more sellers than buyers in the market. Okay. So next we're gonna go ahead and look at Dash. So looking at Dash is down 9.51%. I could tell you guys that their last trade was at $358.52. And look at the market, it gave us a push to go down. Lets us know that there wasn't no interest in higher prices. The market came and closed around 400 and it closed around 350. So that's like a $50 drop. The volume is not as high as yesterday, but the volume is a lot heavier than previous days if you exclude yesterday's volume. So that kind of resembles a push to go down. That also tells us that there was more sellers in the market yesterday than buyers, because if it was not so, then the market would have moved higher today. So we want to be cautious with Dash. The market may continue to trade sideways from this area, but we would like to see the market move lower, because this gives us a precursor of weakness and it kind of lets us know that they are currently not interested in higher prices. So we're expecting Dash to move sideways to lower. Okay. But if the market closes higher than today's bar, then expect Dash to resume its precursor of strength and to move higher. So next, we're going to go ahead and check out NIO. So NEO on the daily chart gives us, pay attention, you guys see the market came down yesterday, closed lower than the previous day. The market came down almost to exactly the same spot of the 26th of August. It came down that same area today, but the market was able to close higher. So that lets us know that the buyers overcame the sellers. We're expecting NEO to move higher. The volume was also a lot heavier than yesterday, so also gives us inclination that the buyers were willing to consume and buy up all the excess selling that was occurring on yesterday's bar. So NEO looks to move higher. So now we're going to go to check out Ethereum Classic. So we also said that yesterday Ethereum Classic was going to move sideways to higher because yesterday's bar was a trial run. Today gives us confirmation that it was successful. So we're expecting Ethereum Classic to also move higher. They are up 5.91%. Last trade was at $16.14. So the market came and closed right here around the area of resistance from August the 6th through the 9th. Okay. We're expecting Ethereum Classic to stay above that area on tomorrow's bar because it took a lot of effort, a lot of push to move this market to that area. And it looks like that the push is still there. So we're expecting Ethereum Classic to continue to move higher. So the last one we're going to look at is Monero. They are down 4.78%. Last trade was $130.40. Now they are almost as similar to Dash on the push to go down. But if you guys notice that consumption came in and the market participants were willing to buy up the price as it moved lower so that it closed right around $130. So obviously Monero is a lot stronger than Dash. With that being said, we are expecting Monero to trade sideways to possibly even higher if this trial run is in fact successful. If it is not successful, then Monero will continue to move lower. But it tells us that all the stockpile that occurred on the 26th of August, that obviously someone was willing to consume that stockpile so that the price was able to close around 130. So Monero, we're expecting to trade sideways to possibly higher. But we would like to see the finishing of this bar before we will make a definitive stance on where Monero will trade. But we're still showing more strength, precursors of strength for Monero than we are Dash. So we're more to leaning to the strength side for Monero than we are for Dash. So with that being said, we're looking for Monero to trade sideways to possibly higher. So that's all we got here at Houfin News. It's amazing how you can come and do a quick cryptocurrency market analysis in almost less than 15 minutes on 9 cryptocurrencies, and you can still predict with a high degree of certainty where the market's going to go. And that's what we do here at Houfin News. We give you guys news according to the charts. Now, we're not investment advisors, nor are we giving you guys investment advice, but we do know where the market is going because it tells us based off the price bars and the volume. And I want you guys to continue to watch these videos because you also will begin to see that man, you know, Houfin News, they are on point with where they know the cryptocurrency are going to go. And how do they know this? Because we took the time to actually learn the language of the markets, and it's a powerful language. And once you learn it, you can also make a substantial amount of money in the market whenever you guys wants to get in the market. That's powerful. And not only that, once you learn this market, you will always, I'm sorry, once you learn this language, you will always have it with you. So that's all I got for today. I appreciate you guys subscribing. I appreciate you guys liking and sharing these videos. If you guys got any questions or comments, go ahead and leave them in the comment section. Again, this is what we do here at Hufin News. We give you guys the daily cryptocurrency market analysis so you guys can implement our analysis into your strategy, possibly to see where the market is going to go. And we are confident in understanding where this language is and where the market is going to go. So that's all I got. I'll talk to you guys later. You guys have a wonderful day.